with all the changes that have happened this season, congratulations on not being one of those changes, but what are your thoughts on the whole new format?
Well, you know what? I love it so far. So far, it seems to be really working. And what I love about it is we had Yaya and Jim on tonight, and you know, she's a crumper and he's a ballet guy, and we got our ballet boy dancing to Bob Marley, which is kind of amazing, and he did a really good job. And she also, not only did he elevate himself to her standard, but she also really helped him too, which is a really lovely thing to see as well. So I think Bob would have been very, very happy, I'm sure, smoking a fat blunt in the sky and saying, yep, I am enjoying this.
With the 10 year anniversary coming up, what are there any standout performances or dancers that you've seen over the years?
Oh my goodness, yeah, there are so many. There's you know, there's the girls that Jasmine and Comfort. I just saw Comfort in the corridor. I'm like, are you still running the world? She's like, yeah, I'm all over it. I'm like, thank God for that. They're going to be on. There's people like Travis. He's coming on to do the bench routine from Mia Michaels. And you know, he's one of the dancers that I'm most proud of. It's a really amazing moment when you take somebody who was part of the competition and then they go through, and you know, he didn't win, but he's now being nominated for an Emmy himself because he's so talented and a bit of a genius. And that's incredibly, makes me really proud. So there's all those kind of moments, and there's going to be silly moments and goofy moments. I'm sure I'll have a few. I'm sure I'll whack Nigel in the face or do something, and then there'll be really emotional moments and it'll be really cool.
Well, after all these years, does anything surprise you?
It takes a lot to surprise me now, because the one big surprise I once had on the show was where we did the results and I didn't know this, and I said to Nigel, okay, so who's going home? And he went, no one's going home. So I made the rest of the show up live on air, and we managed to just about get it off. And I think that we just about got it off on time, and I needed years of therapy and a very large martini to get over it. But now I'm fine. I can pretty much deal with anything.
Everyone, send Kat Dealey martini.
Yes. Yes. It's only been 10 years, for God's sake. I need them.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. And Kat, real quick, back to tonight.
Yeah.
Show, always tough.
It's horrible.
Do you think America got it right this week with the bottom six?
You know what? It's so hard to say at this stage. It's really, really difficult because you haven't really seen how everybody's... You've only seen a little snippet of them. And yes, they have amazing star quality and amazing talent to get them here this far into the top 20. But you have no idea how much they can grow. You have no idea how much they're capable of. So you kind of feel a bit like... their butterflies and their wings have come, like, you, I don't know, you don't know whether they've got it right. And that's always the shame of the first week, is you kind of want to see them a few weeks more really before you can properly make it a guess. But we have to lose somebody every week, otherwise we'd be on air, you know, 52 weeks a year.
But still, we have so much to celebrate from tonight's show.
Yeah.
That closing number, can you just tell us about how was the air backstage?
It's great. I mean, the opening number was amazing. That was my favorite number of the night. And I really like it when the stage and street guys get together, because I think they elevate each other then. And I love the feel of the Day of the Dead, and I just love the hair and makeup and everything. I'm such a girl when it comes to all that. But then you take something like Christopher Scott's routine, where, you know, you've got 10 street dancers that all do different styles, and then he throws in 6 seesaws as well. I mean, surely he's sadomasochistic, not a choreo. Like, it's insane. And then you've got Travis's amazing routine, where I know that Travis was feeling the pressure because he thought that maybe Team Street did better last week. And so he was like, nope, we are turning these into warriors. They're going to be gods and goddesses on top of Mount Vesuvius, and we are going to rule the score. And so he did a great job too.
Amazing. You look beautiful.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you.